Paul, what comes to mind when you think of that word? I think it changes depending on whom you ask. Maybe a mother has a picture of a table with all the family united. A father may think of the sacrifice that it cost him to actually buy that structure. Perhaps a teenager can think in terms of the place to avoid. I would say that in general is a place that makes you feel you belong, with your bed, your personal effects, your memories. It's a place where you're putting your roots down, where you find refuge in the midst of this crazy and more crazy world that surrounds us. However, even though some of us might have felt constricted, being imprisoned in our home, just saying, I'm going home, just gives you that feeling of protection, of warmth. Often when I meet new people, I'm asked, where is home for you? And honestly, that is not an easy question to answer, even though it seems so trivial. Is it my birthplace? Is the current above that I live in? Is the place where I have the most friends or the best memories? And for some of us, really, this is a challenging question. Reflecting on this question, actually, I can say that I don't feel at home anywhere, really, right now. I was born in Italy, raised in the United States, went back and forth numerous times between the States and Italy, and then moved to California, Florida, Tennessee, and poor Jane. Since we have been married, we have moved 16 different times. Let's not talk about the kids. They had to go through a lot themselves. Different school, different friends, adjusting to different languages and mindsets. But however, through that, they've learned to be truly cosmopolitan. Back to me, the other day I had a conversation with the pastor of a church in Florida that is expanding quite rapidly. And he asked me a simple but very perceptive question. He said, Peppo, would you be happy to stay on one location for an extended period of time? And I told him, I need to think about this one. I don't want to just respond impulsively. I don't deny that having visited 92 different countries and lived in 3 different continents has its charm. However, at 60, I feel that I would like to have a place that I can call my home, a place where the children and the grandchildren can come and share memories, and a place that becomes a destination where we can build a legacy together. I really appreciate the different places that I lived in, and most of all, I appreciated the friendships that we were able to create. But honestly, I really don't feel at home on this earth. It's really weird. And I would like to read a couple of scriptures regarding this. Colossians 3:2 says, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. And also Philippians chapter 3 says something else, says, our citizenship is in heaven. Maybe this is what misleads me. The fact that my citizenship is elsewhere. I'm thinking forward to what awaits me. Am I the only one that is going nutso? Am I the only crazy one that is thinking this way? There is another scripture that Paul writes and is in 2 Corinthians 5, where he says, for we know that if our earthly tent, which is our house, is torn down, we have a building from God, a house not made by hands, but eternal in the heavens. For in this tent we groan, wanting to be clothed with our heavenly home. When Paul refers to a tent, he talks about our earthly body, just temporarily here on earth, awaiting something new that the Heavenly Father has prepared for us. Well, I can't wait to trade this tired, broken up body after so many years of intense training for for a new supernatural body in a place, in a dwelling that he prepared for me specifically. And perhaps this is the dilemma, that even though we might live in a beautiful dwelling place here on earth, it is still only and always a tent in comparison to the dwelling place that he has, the mansion that he prepared for us in heaven. And that brings that conflict inside of me. Let me know your point of view, your comments. If you are not subscribed yet, please do so. Remember, the English version will have the American flag. The Italian version will have the Italian flag on the upper left corner. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you next week.